The most important question, number one, do you think pilots are cool?
Yes.
All right, we're gonna get along.
Hi, my name is TJ, and I'm 9 years old.
TJ, have you ever met a pilot?
I've been to Hawaii twice, but I've never seen a pilot.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Hi, I'm James, and I've been a pilot since I was 17 years old. I got my license when I was in high school. I've always wanted to fly ever since I was a kid. I'm an 80s kid, so watching the movie Top Gun, as soon as I saw the planes in that movie, I just decided that I wanted to start flying. When I was a kid, I don't really know how much I knew about airplanes. I just knew that they flew. I didn't really know how, but I knew that I wanted to learn how they flew. Hi, I'm James. What's your name?
TJ.
TJ, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
How do you think that airplanes actually fly?
I think they fly because of the engine they have. Mm. They have this race car steering wheel thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah, okay.
Yeah, and then they pull it, and then they just slowly drift up, slowly go down. The wheels help it slow down for the plane to land to that area.
So when a plane is taking off, how do you think the plane actually lifts off the ground? Like when birds fly, what do they use?
They use their wings.
Right, so what do you think a plane uses?
Their wings.
There you go. So wings combined with
air
and speed, right?
Mm-hmm.
So as the plane's going faster and faster, it generates more and more lift with the wings. And the air going over the wings, that actually creates the lift that lets the plane take off.
The first airplane to take off was in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina.
Oh, you know that.
And then, everyone was like, you know what? Let's copy Kitty Hawk and then just fly planes everywhere.
December 17th, 1903 is when they first flew. Do you know how long they flew for?
3 seconds.
12 seconds.
And I read that airplanes, like when they're flying from like Iceland to like New Zealand, they need way more fuel.
It's
going to be
a really
long flight, like 16
flight.
Hours.
16 hours. Do you know how long the longest flight ever was?
A week. Over a week?
The longest flight was about 19 hours.
19 hours?
Time to get on a plane, yeah.
That's nothing.
Nothing?
That's nothing.
19 hours? What would you do on a plane for 19 hours? You watch a lot of movies?
Or I'm just going to get my papers. Hey, can I sign your autograph, pilot?
You could. So how fast do you think planes are flying when they're in the sky? How fast do you think like commercial airlines
130...
fly?
135.
A little more.
140.
It's about 500.
500?
About between 500, average 500, 550 miles an hour is about how fast planes fly when they're up in the sky.
What if like the shortest flight was like 3 seconds, like Hesperia to San Francisco, like ding, we're here.
Yep. So how high do you think the planes fly?
Above 125, above clouds.
125 feet?
Meters.
Meters, oh gosh, I don't know meters. Most airlines fly between 30 to 40,000 feet on average.
I once had this dream that we were flying a plane and that we were like above Seattle, but next door was Beijing, China. Like it was so weird.
Next door, that's a quick flight to China. Can you see yourself being a pilot? Do you want to fly planes?
Kind of.
Yeah, you do. I know you do.
Yeah, I do.
Have you ever been up in a smaller plane?
I don't think so.
You should do it. It's fun. What do you think the difference is between the really big planes and the little ones?
I think I can see the difference because of the wheels. Like, the wheels are like, I'd say like this tiny. Yeah, and then it's like bigger than you.
Yeah, on the big planes.
Yeah.
Also the engines too, right? See, this one's got a propeller. A lot of smaller planes are propeller driven, whereas the big planes you fly are
big
jet engines. Yeah, big jet engines, yeah.
I'd say like they're the size of like 300 meters.
300 meters, you like meters, don't you?
Yeah, and I see this guy like having these two sticks and then like doing like those signals.
The guy in the text, that's the ramp agent. Mm-hmm. So he basically tells you keep coming forward. There's a bunch of different motions that mean different things, like turn left, turn right, and then the cross means stop. So you know how there's a lot of traffic like in LA and the 405 and all that?
Yeah.
How do you think traffic is organized in the sky? How do you think we don't run into each other?
I think it has something to do with like the speed. So I think when another airplane goes by, you have to slow down, and then it's like,
yep. Actually, when you're flying, it's actually really hard to see other planes because the sky is so big. You ever heard of air traffic control?
No.
Okay. So these people at the airport, so you ever seen those big towers with the glass windows all around it? Inside those glass towers, there's a bunch of people with radios on. We have radios as well. And so we're talking back and forth. We're letting the air traffic controllers know where we are and where we're going. Okay, so when we're flying, you know, we're really up high in the sky. When you look out, you can't really see anything. So how do you think we know where we're going?
They use a GDP.
GDP.
I mean, GDP. GPS.
Oh, there you go, GPS. Very cool. What do you think pilots used before GPS? Because GPS is relatively new.
They used a map.
There you go, a map. Very good. We use maps and also what's called a VFR chart.
Whoa.
This is a VFR chart, and basically it's got all the airports. This is LAX, this is Burbank, this is Van Nuys Airport.
This looks like Pac-Man.
It does, doesn't it? When you're flying a plane, imagine having this while you're trying to fly a plane, right? It's just too cumbersome, so we don't use this anymore. So now we use this thing. Some of these are built into the screens, like on the actual plane, and some people have them like as an iPad, like this.
Oh.
And so basically what you just saw there is now on the screen.
Oh, wow. Okay. Is that like a Samsung?
This is an iPad.
Oh,
iPad.
I have an iPad Pro.
Oh, wow, man, you're ahead of me. Do you know what a pre-flight check is?
Heard that you can't walk underneath the wing of the plane.
Oh, I do it all the time. Are you not supposed to? As like a passenger, you don't get anywhere near besides the steps. But as a pilot, you have to go underneath the wings. So you have a whole list of things that you want to check before you actually get in the plane. So you go and you check like the tires, the lights, the wings, all the controls.
Is there like a gas station for airplanes?
There is a gas station for airplanes. Yeah, they're on the airports. Most of the time they have fuel trucks. Or if you had a smaller airport, they'll have like a self-serve kind of station. You kind of fill it up and go. All right, TJ, so the most important part of being a pilot, since I know you're going to be one day, to have some aviators. You can't take flight school without having aviators.
And then when it's too sunny, just put on your glasses.
That's it.
Like a boss.
You got it. He's cooler than me already.
I learned that all airplanes have an engine, and then the plane check thingy,
pre-flight check.
Yeah. They check the engines, the wheels, the wings, they check everything on the plane. And then I learned that they didn't have GPS back in the day, they actually had to use the map, and then they invented GPS. That's really cool to learn.
He knew a lot more than I thought he would. Clearly he's a very smart kid, and he's going places, and I think he'll make a good pilot one day.
Thank you.